Good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with Rajya Sabha News. Let's begin the bulletin with the headlines. Despite Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu's taking the initiative and ensuring the Home Minister's presence in the House, opposition uproar prevents Rajnath Singh from responding to concerns on Assam's National Register of Citizens. Disruption forced adjournment for the day. Crucial bills on upper house's agenda this week. Government looks to pass triple talaq bill and amendments in the motor vehicles bill. Minister of State Parliamentary Affairs Vijay Goyal informs Rajya Sabha about government's business. First ever parliamentary survey to be conducted in India. 55 districts identified for the survey in 2018 and 19, informs Minister of State for Environment Mahesh Sharma in a written reply. Rajya Sabha proceedings were disrupted on Monday over Assam's NRC issue, resulting in two adjournments in the pre-lunch sitting. This was despite Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu telling opposition members that a discussion will be allowed on the issue. Despite the assurance, opposition members continued to protest, stalling 0 hour and question hour.
The upper house witnessed disruptions over the publication of the second and final draft of Assam's National Register of Citizens. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu stressed that he himself had requested the Home Minister to come to respond to the members' concern. Home Minister Rajnath Singh was present in the house.
Some members met me just now. They wanted to discuss about National Register publication. And I myself have requested the Home Minister to come. I am ready for a discussion. I want the Home Minister to respond. I am for discussion. What is it you want?
When the upper house resumed at noon, members from opposition parties like the Congress, TMC and Samajwadi Party raised the issue once again. As the members refused to relent, the chairman adjourned the house till 2 p.m.
House is adjourned to meet at 2 p.m.
When the house reconvened at 2 p.m. after the last adjournment, TMC leader Derek O'Brien demanded a discussion on the notice given by him. Chairman Naidu reiterated that he had called the Home Minister to the House to respond on the issue, but the House was not in order before adjourning the House for 10 minutes.
Whatever I have to say, I said in the morning, I have decided to allow in the 0 hour. I told the honourable members, then I myself took initiative, called the Home Minister. Home Minister all the way came to the House. Neither the members were willing to say anything or allow the House to function. You can't expect me to do miracles.
When the House reconvened at 2:11 p.m., Derek O'Brien once again demanded a discussion on the issue.
Political issue, sir. It's a question of human rights. It's a humanitarian issue. It's a national issue. Indian citizens, sir. We need to look after Indian citizens.
The house was not in order. I appealed that everyone sit and I called the Home Minister. Home Minister was good enough to come to the house. We could not utilize that opportunity. I assure you, I will give the first opportunity tomorrow morning in the beginning of the session itself.
With the TMC member unrelenting and other TMC members joining him in raising the issue, Chairman Naidu adjourned the house for the day.
The house is adjourned to meet tomorrow at 11 a.m.
Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs Vijay Goyal informed the upper house about the government business for this week. The house will continue discussion on the National Council for Teacher Education Amendment Bill 2018. The upper house will also consider the passing of the Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill 2017 and the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Amendment Bill 2018, among others.
I rise to announce the government business during the week commencing Monday, the 30 July 2018, will consist of further consideration and passing of the National Council for Teacher Education Amendment Bill 2018, consideration and passing of the following bills as passed by Lok Sabha: the Muslim Woman Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill 2017 and the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Amendment Bill 2018, consideration and passing of the following bills after they are passed by Lok Sabha: the Homeopathy Central Council Amendment Bill 2018 to replace an ordinance, the Criminal Law Amendment Bill 2018 to replace an ordinance, the Commercial Courts Commercial Division and Commercial Appellate Division of High Courts Amendment Bill 2018 to replace an ordinance, the National Medical Commission Bill 2017, the Banning of Unregulated Deposit Scheme Bill 2018, the New Delhi International Arbitration Centre Bill 2018, the Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Bill 2018, the Trafficking of Persons Prevention, Protection and Rehabilitation Bill 2018, the Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Development Amendment Bill 2018, the Dentist Amendment Bill 2017, the Representation of People's Amendment Bill 2017, and the Consumer Protection Bill 2018, the Public Premises Eviction of Unauthorized Occupants Amendment Bill 2017.
Please.
Further consideration and passing of the Motor Vehicles Amendment Bill 2017 as passed by Lok Sabha and as reported by the Select Committee of Rajya Sabha. Discussion on statutory resolution seeking disapproval of the National Sports University Ordinance 2018, number 5 of 2018, and consideration and passing of the National Sports University Bill 2018 after it's passed by Lok Sabha. Discussion on statutory resolution seeking disapproval of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Ordinance 2018, number 6 of 2018, and consideration and passing of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Bill 2018 after it is passed by Lok Sabha.
And for the first time ever, the government is going to conduct an environmental survey covering various parameters like flora, fauna and pollution. The government has identified around 55 districts across the country for the survey. Minister of State for Environment, Mahesh Sharma, in a written reply in the Rajya Sabha said, a national environment survey is proposed under the ongoing Environmental Information System scheme of the ministry. He said that the data emerging from the survey would contribute significantly towards valuation of ecosystem services at district, state and national levels and arriving at their respective green gross domestic product. He was asked whether the government would begin a five-year exercise to compute district-level data on the country's environment health. Ministers made statements pertaining to their ministries on the floor of the upper house.
With your permission, I rise to make a statement regarding the status of implementation of recommendations and observations contained in the 45th report of the Department-related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Information Technology on demands for grants 2018-19 pertaining to the Ministry of Information Broadcasting.
आज के संशोधित कार्यसूची में क्रम संख्या 2 पर मेरे नाम के सामने उल्लेखित ग्रामीण विकास विभाग के अनुदान मांगों के संबंध में ग्रामीण विकास संबंधी स्थायी समिति के 28वीं रिपोर्ट में अंतर्विष्ट सिफारिशों के क्रियान्वयन की स्थिति सदन में प्रस्तुत कर रहा हूँ।
With your permission, I want to make a statement regarding status of implementation of recommendation oblique observation contained in the 20th report of the Department related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Water Resources on Demand for Grants 2018-19 pertaining to the Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. Thank you.
I rise to lay on the table of the House a copy, each in English and Hindi, of the following statement mentioned against my name. That is, status of implementation of recommendations contained in the 21st report of the Department-related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Defence on Demands of Grant 2016-17 Miscellaneous Demand No. 20 pertaining to the Ministry of Defence.
And members of the upper house mourned the passing away of N. Thangaraj Pandian, a former member of Rajya Sabha. Pandian represented the state of Tamil Nadu from June 1992 to June 1998 in the upper house. He passed away on July 17, 2017 at the age of 61 years. Members stood in their places as a mark of respect for the departed soul.
I refer with profound sorrow to the passing away of Sri N. Thangaraj Pandian, former member of this house, on the 17th of July 2017 at the age of 61 years. Born in July 1956 at Kurthalam in the Tirunelveli district of Tamil Nadu, Sri Pandian was educated at the RP High School, Idanji, the MDT Hindu College, Tirunelveli, and the Thiruvallar College, Papanasanam. An agriculturist, Sri Thangaraj Pandian was involved in trade union and social welfare activities. He served as the president of Veera Keralam Pudur Panchayat in Tirunelveli district of Tamil Nadu and as Vice Chairman of the Kedapavur Panchayat Union, Sri N. Thyagaraj Pandian represented the state of Tamil Nadu in this House from June 1992 to June 1998. In the passing away of Sri N. Thyagaraj Pandian, the country has lost a distinguished parliamentarian. We deeply mourn the passing away of Sri N. Thyagaraj Pandian.
And that's all we have for you in this edition. Thank you for watching.